This is how you can set alerts on EzAlgo V3.5 so you're not staring in front of your computer screen for 12 hours a day trying to find that entry. Instead, what you can do is create an alert on TradingView and have it notify you via pop-up, email, or even a webhook to an API bot, so you're not manually in front of your computer all day, because I know time is a huge issue for most people that want to get into trading. They don't have the time to sit there staring at charts for hours a day, and they end up missing entries. So in the recent EzAlgo update, we've added a couple more alerts, and I'm going to go through how you can set them up and some best practices and what alerts I have set up so you can do the same thing. So I'm over here on Tesla right now, and believe it or not, EzAlgo works even better on stocks, right? Most people think it only works on crypto and Forex because most of our traders only trade crypto or Forex, but the truth is it works extremely well on some of these stocks, right? I'm on the 1 hour Tesla time frame, and if you were to just enter some simple option signals based on these alerts, and of course the support and resistance levels, you'd be doing very well for yourself. So, and first thing I'm gonna do is go through my EzAlgo settings to show you exactly what my settings look like when I'm creating these alerts. So the sensitivity really just depends on the asset and the time frame. I actually do enjoy the lower sensitivities, like the one sensitivity. It just gives you that buy or sell signal a lot earlier. So if price is at a support or resistance zone, these signals will come up a lot sooner, as opposed to if you had, let's say, a 1.5 sensitivity. You know, the signals are still accurate, but you'll see in just a second they're a little bit more delayed. So I do like those quick signals because I'm not going to be taking every single one. Even though I create alerts, I'm only going to be taking the signals that are at a support or resistance zone. I turn the stop loss off to zero. That's pretty self-explanatory. We have the trend ribbon, and I have SR1 on. And since we're on the 1 hour time frame, I don't really need SR2, so I'm just going to keep the SR1 for now. And the reversal signals, of course, are going to be turned on, and everything else is going to be turned off. So what you're going to do is come up here to the top right of your screen and press create alert, or you can press alt A on your keyboard, and you're going to make sure the condition is EzAlgo 3.5. All right, most people get this confused and they press the condition on the asset that they're trading. You want to set the condition to EzAlgo V3.5, and here you will see all of our signals, right? We have the buy signal, the buy or sell signal, price breaks SR, reversal signal, and sell signal. So these are pretty self-explanatory. So for those of you that only want to be taking trades at support or resistance levels, which is what I recommend, definitely be sure to set an alert to price breaks SR level. And this is also very helpful because sometimes if price finds support in the middle of a range, then a support level will form in real time, but price doesn't necessarily go through that level. So if you want to trade based off of the levels that are already there on the screen, then definitely be sure to set an alert to price breaks SR. We have the reversal signals. Now, you guys know this, but you're not supposed to take a trade based on a reversal signal or any of these signals. You want confluence with multiple different indicators within EzAlgo to take your trade, right? But this can be very helpful. So, you know, you can also create an alert for the reversal signal. But for example, we're going to say we're just going to be setting an alert for the buy signal. Make sure this is once per bar close, okay? Because if not, a signal might flash and you might get an alert and then the signal disappears, all right? And it messes it all up. So make sure it is once per bar close. Super, super important. And then, you know, you can have it notify you via app, pop-up, email, or a webhook if you have an API bot that you'd like to connect to EzAlgo, and you have your own list of rules of what you need to see before you enter a trade. You can code that into an API bot and then send a webhook from EzAlgo to that bot so it can trade for you automatically. And then obviously you can make an alert name. So for example, I can do Tesla buy signal 1 hour time frame with a custom message right here. Now, it's very important to note that the alerts will only go through on the time frame that you are on when you create the alert. So for example, if I'm on the 1 hour time frame and I create an alert for the buy signal, that buy signal is going to be on the 1 hour time frame. So if I wanted to create another alert for the 15 minute time frame, I'm going to have to manually go back to the 15 time frame on TradingView and create another alert here on the 15 minute time frame and do the same thing. And of course, if you like to create alerts on other assets, you must go to another asset on TradingView, press create alert again, and do it that way. Now, there's multiple ways that you can use the alerts, right? The first way you can use an alert is if you're on a higher time frame, okay? So if you're worried about missing a potential signal on, let's say, the 1 hour, 2 hour, 4 hour, even daily time frame, You can just create an alert for a buy or sell signal or a reversal signal or any of the alerts that we have on here. So you have a general idea that the market could reverse after this signal. And this works very well on some low cap crypto coins. So for all of you that are interested in those low cap altcoins, what you can do, and this is what I've done, is go to a daily time frame, even a 2 day or 3 day time frame, right? And you can create alerts for the buy and sell signals. That way you know when to re-enter the market and when to sell your position so you're not caught bag holding. If you're trading something like stock options, you can create an alert and enter option signals based off of the support and resistance levels. For example, we had this resistance zone right here. You could simply enter option puts for each sell signal following this resistance level. And same thing for a buy signal, right? You can enter calls after every buy signal that you get at the support zone. Same thing, right? Comes up to this resistance zone and we have a sell signal. You can enter a put right there. Retest that zone with a buy signal, right? You can enter a call right there and just play the levels. This also works well on Forex. So you can also create an alert for a Forex pair that you're trading. And really anything that is on TradingView, you can create an alert for. And make sure that you don't miss out on that trade. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to get EzAlgo yourself. It is the best buy-sell indicator and overall technical indicator on TradingView. So hit the first link in the description below if you'd like to get it yourself. And I'll see you guys next video.